Hey everybody, Rob here at etrailer.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Stealth Hitches hidden rack receiver on our 2019 Volvo V60. Now believe it or not, we actually have our hitch in place right now, and that's a really nice thing about the Stealth Hitches. Our Volvo is going to look exactly the same as it did the day that it came off the factory floor when we're not using our hitch. When we do want to use it, we have a removable receiver tube. That way we can still keep that clean look, but the option to use the hitch when we need to. It's going to work extremely easy. We're going to get a 2-inch receiver tube opening, and you'll see this end is just going to feed up into the hitch. Once we have it lined up, simply just push it up, and it'll lock right into place. And then on the driver's side, we have a tab. We push in, and that's gonna lock it into place, so we don't have to worry about somebody tampering with it. Here you can see the lock. It is a barrel style lock, so it is gonna prevent somebody trying to pick it. It's definitely a lot harder to pick these style locks than a traditional lock. But again, once you slide the receiver tube in, just push that button in, lock it down, and it even has a dust cover to keep all the debris and dust out, make sure that lock core stays nice and clean and working order. And then the large knob on the passenger side is how we're going to remove the receiver tube from the rack. Just grab that knob and we can turn it. And you can see the receiver tube's going to pop right out. There is a plug, so we can put the plug in there whenever we're not towing, keep all that dirt and debris out. But again, it's just really nice to be able to remove that receiver tube and not have something big hanging off the back of our car. Now I do want to mention, you'll see that we have these safety chain connection points on either side of the rack here, but that's because there's actually two different packages that come for our Volvo. This package actually is the towing package, so we still get that receiver tube and the actual hitch itself, but the towing package is going to come with safety chain connection points as well as wiring. That way we can hook up and put a ball mount in there as well. And that's another thing I do want to mention. Our receiver tube here, although it is a 2-inch by 2-inch receiver tube, and we have a hitch pin hole able to use it, we do not want to put a ball mount in here. This is not for towing. This is only rated for hitch mounted accessories like a bike rack or a cargo carrier. But if you do plan on doing some towing, the tow package along with the Stealth Hitch, again, is going to give you that ball mount, the wiring, and everything else. And I suggest if you do plan on doing towing, even if it is a little bit, I would go with the towing package because the install is gonna be a lot easier if you do it all at once rather than having the hitch put on and then having to take a few pieces off just to get the wiring in place. Now, since our rack receiver is gonna be that 2-inch by 2-inch receiver tube opening, it's gonna give us the widest variety of options when it comes to accessories that we can mount up. A 2-inch receiver tube is going to be the most common size when it comes to accessories like bike racks or cargo carriers. But at the same time, if you have a vehicle in your family that happens to have an inch and a quarter hitch, there is a separate adapter. It's actually a whole different receiver tube that'll be 1¼ by 1¼. So if you have a few different vehicles in your family that have a few different hitches on them, maybe you carry a few different accessories like bike racks, that'd be a good option to get as well. Now, one thing I know a lot of customers are going to be wondering about is if the hitch is going to interfere with the rear liftgate sensors. And I'll let you know right now, it's not going to, but obviously we can't put our foot where the receiver tube is, so we're going to have to move to either side. But once you do, the liftgate's still going to work just like normal. It'll open up and the receiver tube or the ball mount aren't going to get in the way. Now I'd like to give you a few measurements, and these are going to help you whenever you're looking for accessories for your new hitch, like a bike rack or a cargo carrier for the receiver tube opening. Now you'll notice that our receiver tube actually sticks out past the bumper, but the hitch pin hole is just slightly in from the outer edge. There's about 2 inches of difference there, so you just want to make sure that if you're looking at folding accessories, that the shank has at least 2 inches so that we can put them in the upright stored position and not make contact with the rear bumper here. Another thing to keep in mind is our V60 sits a little low to the ground. It's not extremely low, but a raised shank on a bike rack or a cargo carrier would definitely help out, give us a little bit more ground clearance so we don't have to worry about bottoming out as much. Now, as far as the installation, I will let you know it is a little bit in depth. We are going to have to remove the rear fascia because our hitch is behind everything. So in order to get that clean look, we're going to have to remove a few panels temporarily. And there is a little bit of minor trimming that we're going to have to do, but you can't even see it unless you really get underneath the car. And there's already an existing hole there, so we're really just enlarging it a little bit. There's not really any special tools that you will need to get the hitch in place, but you do want to make sure you have an extra set of hands with you and that you have a little bit of time, because it's not going to be a 20-minute process. In fact, let's go and make sure that you do feel comfortable doing it home. We'll walk you through all the steps that we did to get it in place. To begin our installation, we want to open up the rear hatch on our Volvo. And if we come to the very corner, right below our taillight where the hatch opens, we're going to find a push pin on each corner. Now we need to remove those, so we can grab a flat blade screwdriver. And if we look at the push pin, there's going to be an outer ring and a center section. So that little center section actually needs to get pushed in. So we'll take our screwdriver and you just want to push, it'll kind of pop in there. And then we want to come underneath and pry the push pin out. Now the one on the other side is going to work the same way. So we'll go over there and pop that center section in and pop the push pin out. Next, we can move to the rear wheel well. Just inside the liner here, right behind the tire, we're going to have several screws that are going along the edge. It should be a total of 5 of them. Now they're Torx bit heads, so we want to use a T25 Torx bit. And I recommend using a small driver like this just because of the limited space between the tire and the liner itself. But we want to pull all 5 of those out. We'll pull all 5 of them out on this side. We'll move over to the other side and pull the 5 out over there. And with all the screws removed, we're gonna grab the liner, kind of push it out of the way for now, kind of catch it on the tread of the tire. And if we look right where the fender meets the fascia, we're gonna have that body seam right here. On the inside behind the liner, we're gonna have another Torx screw that's going down. So the head of the screw is going to be on top, and it's going to be that same T25 Torx bit. It's a little difficult to see, but it's right inside the liner, right where the fender meets the fascia. But we need to pull that out, so we'll use that same driver and pull that bolt out. Now if we move to the back underside of our Volvo, just the inside of where our exhaust is, we're going to have 2 screws. They're going to be on each side. We need to pull those out as well. We're going to use that same T25 Torx bit. So at this point, I recommend getting an extra set of hands so we can remove the fascia. It's not very heavy, but we don't want to scratch it. So we're going to start at the very bottom where the fender meets the fascia. And we're going to start pulling away. We'll start releasing the clips. Now once you get to about this area, you may need to grab underneath. And start working it loose. However, we are gonna have an electrical connector on the passenger side. It's gonna be a large connector. It's directly underneath the taillight all the way on the passenger side. You just push in on the tab. And disconnect the connector, then we can set our fascia aside where it won't get damaged. So with the fascia out of the way, that's going to expose the bumper beam and the plastic support that's on top of it. So we want to grab a 8mm socket, and we're going to remove the 4 bolts that are holding that plastic retainer in place. And once you have all the bolts removed, we'll set this plastic piece aside. Now that plastic support's out of the way, that'll give us room to see and get access to the 3 nuts on each side that are holding the bumper beam in place. We'll have 2 on top and then 1 in the center on the bottom. So we'll grab a 15mm socket and pull all 3 of those out. With all 6 removed, we grab our bumper beam. You may have to lift up just a little bit. Might be stuck. We'll grab it and pull it off and set it aside for now. So now we can grab our hitch. We're going to line up the holes on the side plates with the holes in the studs. One thing you do want to pay attention to is that the holes in the center here need to be on the bottom side of the hitch. Now we can grab our bumper beam and we're going to put it right over the studs, sandwiching the hitch in between the body and the bumper beam. So we don't want to reuse the factory nuts. They give us new serrated nuts in your kit. So you just want to take one of the nuts, put it on each one of the studs, making sure everything's nice and secure. And if we get one on each side, at least hand tight, we don't have to worry about anything falling, and everything should support itself and hold it in place. So just go through, put all the nuts on each one of the studs. Then we can take that same 15 millimeter socket and we're going to tighten up all the nuts till they're nice and snug. Now you do want to make sure you come back with a torque wrench and we're going to torque all the hardware down to the specified amount in the instructions. You just want to make sure you go back and repeat that for any remaining hardware that you have. At this point, we want to grab the latching mechanism. Now, you'll notice it's going to have a rubber plug on the bottom. You can leave that rubber plug in there, but just keep in mind that the keys are inside. So if you do leave them in there, just remember you left them in there, or you can take them out and put them somewhere safe. But that's where the keys are going to be if you haven't found them yet. And just remember that they're in there. We don't want to leave them in there all the time. But we'll have two holes on our latching mechanism. It's going to line up with those two holes in the center on the hitch here. So we'll line up the holes, lifting the latching mechanism up. And then we're going to take a long bolt, going all the way through the bracket and the latching mechanism. And on the other side, I'm gonna grab a nylon lock nut. And for now, we just wanna loosely get it installed, just enough to where it'll hold it, and we know that it's gonna thread on there. And we can put the other bolt in. Put the other nut on, and tighten it down. To tighten it down, you can use a 19 millimeter wrench and socket, or you can use a 3/4 inch wrench and socket. Now these half inch bolts also need to get torqued down. So you want to check your instructions because they are going to have a different torque value than the other bolts. You want to make sure you torque them down. And we'll come back, torque the other one down. And with the hitch in place, we can line our plastic panel back up and replace those four screws that we removed earlier. So now we need to move to our fascia. It should still be off the car. If we look at the very bottom where we have that opening, just to the right of that, if you're looking at it, we're gonna have this panel that's holding on our sensor for our lift gate. We need to remove that whole panel. So you can actually just take that panel and slide it over towards that opening. Just slide it over. There's some notches that'll allow it to come out. And once you have it out, we wanna remove the center plug. Just push in on the tab, release it, then we just work those clips out of the holder so that we can get the wire to come off and stay on the fascia. So now with the holder removed, I went ahead and marked out the area that we needed to trim. Now they do give you a diagram in your instructions, but essentially if we come from that large opening, we're going to want to go straight across just a little bit over about an inch and a half or so from the edge of those mounting tabs And then we're just going to make a nice big square hole. So we're going to cut this material out. Now, whenever you're cutting it, you can use just about whatever you have. It is just plastic. But I'm going to be using a rotary tool just so I can make a quick, clean cut. And then we can always come back and file down the edges if we have any sharp edges on there. So even though it's on the bottom, we don't want to leave all this excess plastic and kind of little shreds of plastic on there. So you just take a file, kind of go over the edges. It'll take off that excess plastic pretty easy, give us a nice smooth surface. So now that we have that trimmed out and cleaned up, we need to come back to the panel that's holding the kick wand. And you're going to notice that we actually have two wands on there, the two plugs. We need to mark these because we have to pull them out, but we want to make sure they go back into the proper position. We don't want this lower one up here and vice versa. So you just take a marker. I'm going to mark the lower one. Just put a line on it going across. That way I know this is the lower one. And I'm just going to leave the top one with no marks on it. That way it's easily deciphered which one is which. But once we have them marked out, I'm just going to take the wand itself and start unclipping it until we can get the whole wand out of the holder. Start working our way around, unclipping everything. Now we want to get the module out too, so we're going to press on this tab here and just lift up, and we'll set this aside for right now. So now that we have the module removed, took a few measurements, and again these are going to be in your instructions, but you want to measure over, and we're going to make a straight line and cut this end section off. At the same time though, on the very corner here, we want to trim that just a little notch off the corner. So again, I'm going to be using a rotary tool. Just make a quick clean cut and cut out those sections. So now that we have that trimmed, we want to flip our kick wand over. So this is going to be the side that was actually facing the car when we originally took it off like this. And now we have a total of four holes that we need to drill. The two on the top section, basically you want to drill a hole pretty close to the corner here, and then about, I don't know, midway through in this open area here, you want to put one directly above the actual clip that holds the module in the center, and then one in the center on this lower portion. I'm just going to use a 5/16 drill and bit, and we just want to drill all four of those holes out. So now we want to take our kick wand module, we're going to slide it back into that clip, clip it back in place. Now we want to get the rest of our wands back in as well. Now obviously we don't have all the material left because we trimmed it off, so we just want to get as much of the wand clipped in place as we can. And we're going to tie up the excess over here in the corner. We want to put both the wands back in, and again, just try to remember which one you marked. Top one goes on the top, lower one goes on the lower section, and again, it is going to stick out past the holder, but we just want to get it clipped back in place. Now, since we ended up trimming our panel here, you'll find out real quick that the holder's not going to hold the wands in place very well, but that's why we drilled those holes. It'll allow us to use a zip tie, and then we can zip tie the harness and that wand right to the outside of the panel. We will have a little bit of excess wire here over on the side, but we can always tie these up. But we want to make sure this fits and gets in place properly before we tie everything up. That way we can see how much we actually need. But we'll move our center wire just out of the way for now. And if we look at that second set of notches, towards the back, we're going to have two square holes. We want to line up that hole we drilled with that larger rectangular hole towards the side. So we'll take our wand and everything, and again, kind of need to play with how it's going to sit in there. But we want to line that hole up to where it's going to line up with the hole that we drilled in our bracket. But once we get it lined up and our bracket is nice and even with the hole that we cut and the wands are extending out past that opening, we're going to take one of the nylon bolts coming from the outside. We're going to pass it through. It may be a little bit easier if you remove the module while you're at least attaching it. Just kind of push it out of the way. You can see where that bolt's going to come through. And again, line up the bracket. And we're going to take a nylon nut and secure it down from the back side. Now these are all nylon, so we don't really need to crank on them. You just want to use your fingers to try to get it nice and snug and then double check that it's not going to move around. So once that nut is on there, the panel's nice and snug, we'll clip our module back in place. Make sure it gets all the way in there and that tab's all the way over. Then we can plug in that center plug, reattach the clips. And now we can take all the excess wire and kind of bundle it up here, make sure it stays away from our exhaust on the other side. Now the next set of hands, we're gonna get ready to put our fascia back in place, but you don't wanna forget to plug that plug in on the passenger side. I like to get the sides clipped in. That way I know it's not gonna come off and we don't have to worry about it falling or anything. Now it's just a matter of putting all the hardware back in place in reverse order. So we're just gonna start putting all the fasteners in. Now, these push pins are a little weird to work with. Since we had to push the center in, we want to come to the back and pop it out so it's sticking out. And then make sure it's still sticking out, we're going to put the base in, and then we'll push down on the center to where it's flush, and it'll lock it in place. Once you have that last bolt in and all the panels back in place, that'll finish up your installation and your look at the Stealth Hitch on our 2019 Volvo V60.